Talking to Death is a production of Tenderfoot TV and iHeartPodcasts. Listener discretion is advised.
So, what's up?
How you doing?
How you doing?
What's happening?
What accent is that?
I'm not sure. People say I fake an accent all the time. I don't know what my real one is at all.
Okay, well, just say like...
Boston is what it's supposed to be.
Oh, I could actually hear that a little bit now.
Yeah.
Are you from Boston?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, 30 minutes out, God forbid I actually say Boston.
Are you a Boston sports fan?
So here's the thing. Pats were winning. We were on a winning streak. It was so much fun.
Oh,
high school, lots of parades. You don't know anything about that. I do. Now, they're not winning. I kind of want to jump to Bills Mafia, but that's just me.
I mean, I would support that.
Yeah, I mean, they go crazy. They jump on. I mean, it's for the fans.
Looks fun.
Yeah. I want to join them.
It's like, also, like, I like Stephon Diggs because he's fucking dope.
Who is it?
Stephon Diggs.
Yeah, no, me too, man.
His swag is out of control. He doesn't have to be that cool, but he is.
I have no idea. I have no idea about sports.
You go look up Stephon Diggs when you leave here and you go, damn, he's pretty tight.
All right.
Yeah,
I'm in.
He is. And is he a model or is he a wide receiver? I don't know.
Shit,
the Bills. Yeah. So you gave me this.
Yep, that's a pirate water.
And I'm gonna try it and just see.
Give it a whirl.
All right. This is Miami Vice pirate water.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's a good 10% bang for your buck.
Though.
That's your bang and that's your buck.
10% what?
In terms of
that's the
whatever ABV
content,
stands
right?
for.
Yeah, it's like 3.5 beers or 2 IPAs.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, well, you're 30. You think in terms of IPAs.
Yeah, how many? Yeah,
I think that's like
how many
three
IPAs
natty lights.
Is that? Well, dude, remember, one IPA is still like 2.5 beers.
Yeah, that's true.
Let's see. Okay.
Moment of truth.
Oh, it smells a little reminiscent.
Smell like Miami?
It's actually not bad.
That's huge to hear.
I can tell there's a lot packing in there.
Yeah.
But I can also see how you could just drink too many of these and be like, I don't know what happened that night. Yeah, it's actually pretty good.
I'm a heavy drinker, have a high tolerance. Two of those, I'm weird. Which is great. They're only $2. That's a $4 night. Not too bad.
The Four Loko is the comparison without the fucking coke in it, basically, right?
Yeah, it's its older brother.
It's
same
so weird.
Company.
So I used to do
coke,
meth. No, I mean,
I never did meth.
I still do those. I used to do I used to be in a band, like rapping and did my own music videos and stuff. And this is circa 2008-09 when I first started doing that, like white rapper pop. Punk vibes, you know.
You give me a sample.
You can Google it and figure it out and see, like, oh yeah, they still exist out there. But
spit a bar.
This oh, hell no.
Nah,
I'll right. send you a link.
Yeah. Right,
and then you'll be like, oh my god, he wasn't kidding.
Yeah.
No, but
that.
This company reached out to me, just cold emailed me in like 2008 or 2009, and they were called Four. It was just Four.
Four.
And they had this drink called Four that was like an energy drink, and it was. Had a lot of alcohol in it.
Ooh.
And they're like, we'll send you these if you put them in your music video.
All right.
And they sent us like a crate of them. And then it became Four Loko.
Oh, and shit.
And then they sent us a whole shit ton of those. And then they like had to wipe the stores of these ones that we had.
First batch didn't go so well.
I was like, I think they call it Four, or like back in the day, Four, because if you have Four, you die.
They didn't want to say die. They were like, we need a rebrand. Let's go. Like we could call it Four Death. We're like, nah, just go Loco. It just makes you a little loco.
Okay, so you have a huge TikTok following. I mean, I have like 1,000 followers on my TikTok.
You know, I'm decent.
Damn, okay. Do you feel cooler?
No, I'll always feel like a loser. I mean, middle school crushed me, man.
Oh shit, what happened?
Well, no, it's like, I don't know. I don't know if it's different between girls and boys in middle school, but something about middle school, I will always be a loser.
Middle school is my least favorite one.
Yeah, it's tough.
Sixth grade was the worst year of my life in school, I think.
That was a tough time.
So why was it so tough for you?
You know, I got jumped a handful of times throughout my school years.
Jumped?
Yeah, not even in fistfights, just absolutely unfairly jumped.
Like stealing your backpack? What are they doing?
No, they just wanted to beat me down mentally and physically. Never taken anything of value because I wasn't of value, really.
Who is they?
You
just
name
like
them.
The older kids, the bullies, or
there
what?
There was these girls who thought I was talking to her boyfriend. I'm still scared of boys to this day. There was this other girl. I was the only one who went to her birthday party in fifth grade. Sixth grade, she decided, you're my target. I'm going to get you in between bells.
This bitch.
She'd come swinging. Fucking teachers would be trying to like box her out, like playing basketball. Another crazy one was I was at a 21 Savage concert night before an AP test. Only AP I ever took.
Good
I didn't know you had to pay for the test at the end of the year. So that's why I took that class. I just thought it would be easy. And so went to a 21 Savage concert, tried to get to the front, and I had some words, probably not great words, with this woman. And her boyfriend stepped in. And he said, you can't talk to my woman like that.
How old are these people?
They're a lot older than 17-year-old me, that's for sure.
Okay.
And homeboy windmilled me at the 21 Savage concert.
Like, literally
like,
punched
one of these?
You?
Yeah. And I was with my best friend, Bree, and the friends were holding her back saying, just let it happen. Just let it happen.
All right, that's like actually fucked.
Yeah, and then 21 Savage said, this all sounds fake, but then 21 Savage stopped the concert. And he was like, y'all wilding down there. And I was like, 21, help.
That's fucked. So, okay, then what happened then?
They ran out. Never got them. They tried to offer me free tickets for the rest of the year, like for one concert.
Who's they?
The House of Blues. Sorry. The
okay.
venue. Yeah.
Yep.
But the only one playing was like Sammy Adams. I don't even know if you know who that is.
I actually do.
Yeah.
Did I just age myself?
Yeah. No, because I know him.
Dude, he had that one song. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, what?
I was like, you been talking about?
Yeah.
I'm going to pull it up.
Yeah, what is that song?
He samples a song that is also a hit.
Yeah.
Like that piano song, the Walking on Glass song.
Yeah.
Walking on glass. Or
Sammy Adams.
Glass. It's something like that.
He's a local hero.
Dude, yeah. So back in the day, I wanted to be that guy.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, like.
He was the man.
And, you know, I guess career-wise, it didn't entirely work out.
I think you ended up a lot cooler. So.
Well, thank you. Yeah. I mean.
No
sure.
disrespect to him.
No, right. But I was like, man, how are these guys doing this? Making smashes like this. Oh, damn. It's not even on his top anymore. Okay, oh, I got it. This.
Sammy Adams.
Okay, I will say, though, the intro is bad. It's,
I don't know. It's pretty tight.
I'm not hype right now. But once the
right?
piano comes, right here.
Oh, yes. Crazy. Sammy Adams, man.
I think what I realized, though, is I actually just like the song they sampled more than that song.
Yeah, that's usually the case.
And it's also a slap.
That's the sampled song? Yeah.
You can't say this song sucks.
No.
It doesn't.
Nope.
So.
You can't not smile when you hear this song.
Yeah. It's like this song comes on, you go... It's going to be okay.
Yeah. It's like, everything's going to be at least decent.
Yeah. That's one of those things I was like, I wasn't listening to that. Like,
I know.
So tell me about your podcasting career so far. Did you like want to do podcasts or, I don't know, like what is it even like these days? Is that a career path?
Yeah.
That
so
is a thing?
Ever since I was a little baby child, I always wanted to be a podcaster. It was a really lucrative decision.
24 years ago?
Yeah.
Yeah,
no.
Me too.
isn't it crazy, though, that it wasn't even like a thing?
Yeah, it's not a thing that you... I'm like, was it at all? Like, in? I mean...
For me, no. The podcasts didn't become relative till... I mean, everyone knew like how Stern had Sirius and like...
Mm-hmm.
But that's still radio in my eyes. Like, podcasts didn't really become... happening in my time till like I was in high school, I guess. But like it was never like a thought.
Yeah.
For me, I guess.
I made Up and Vanished in 2016. I think Serial came out in 2015.
Ahead of its time, though. That was a good time to get in.
That also hurts my head.
Yeah.
And I was like, I didn't think I was getting in to anything. I was just like, maybe I do that.
Yeah,
like,
this would be silly.
Or I was like, and then I'll go on to the next one. Yeah,
it's not going to be like a colossal fail. It wasn't if it that doesn't deep. Work out. Yeah.
But I guess there was probably more of a, I don't know, pathway to it or like, I don't know, proof of concept that,
yeah.
I don't know. Like, what's your, I'm actually just curious about your perspective on how you got to where you are right now and what you saw to make you think that.
So my friend Brianna, she got hired by Barstool when she was a junior in college. And they told her that she had to move to New York to like full-time work there. So she had to drop out of school. But before she moved, she gave me a call. She's like, dude, I know you're taking a semester off of school because it's all online. You want to just come with me to New York, see what happens? I've always wanted to move to New York. But when I got here, I had just enough money saved from scooping ice cream. That was my only source of income. So that was running out fast. I didn't realize how expensive New York was.
Right.
So that was running out. So I started door dashing on foot in the snow.
This sounds like a your uncle's story where walking to school is uphill both ways. You're like, what?
You know, DoorDash. Well, before they had hoverboards, I was on foot.
Right. So you're just like on foot, but like I guess there's a radius, right?
No, they would send you all over Manhattan. It was ridiculous.
But would it take too long to not be worth it?
Yeah, everybody's food was cold. I wasn't making any money. You make your money off of tips on that job, and I was losing. It was tough. It was tough.
It's been 45 minutes. Like, I don't even know if she's in a car.
Like, no, they could see me just slowly moving. Felt bad for all of them, but, you know.
What do you like about just talk on the mic? I mean, it's your job.
Yeah.
And you just get up there and shoot the shit and talk about things that you care about, don't care about, and you're just all day talking.
Yeah.
Why do you like that?
Well, I mean, teachers growing up would just tell me that I'd talk too much during class. And so this is probably the best job ever for that. And the best thing that comes with all of it is that I'm doing it with my best friend since I was 10.
It's amazing.
Which is like super awesome. Like, I just remember being in college and like we'd FaceTime each other and we're talking about how much we hate our major or whatever. And we're like, dude, imagine we just get paid to party with each other. Wouldn't that be sick?
It's like some shit you come up with in the closet. Like, yeah, one day, man.
Yeah. Like a 3 a.m. Like, dude, we should totally get paid to party. And we figured out how to do that, which is fucking sick.
I mean, touche for that. I mean, honestly, that is... That's amazing.
Yeah.
Honestly.
It's pretty damn cool.
These guys are my friends and
that's huge.
That's also cool as fuck.
Yeah.
That I'm able to, because work sucks.
Yeah.
Right? Like, and you still do work, right? We're still doing work.
Yeah, but I've like never had a time where I'm like, damn, I wish I was doing something else.
Right, exactly.
Which is sick.
So I'm gonna shift gears here and you know, within your comfort zone, you tell me what you think. But I was just doing some TikToking and Instagramming. That sounded horrible. No one says that shit.
How old are you again?
52.
Yeah. Sound like my pops.
Yeah. You know, TikToking and Instagramming.
I'm on the gram and I'm the grandma when we do your grandma.
It's like, Dad, you're clearly not because...
Are you dancing on TikTok? Is that what you're doing?
Honestly, I should be.
Yeah, why not?
Don't even get me started. I mean, I like made like one tweet one time. I was like, I was annoyed. I'm like, God, I'm so annoyed at everyone dancing on TikTok. And then someone just read it so deeply that they were like, wow, it upsets you if people are living their life and having fun.
So these are the people that we are annoyed with. It's just like, shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up.
So now you are analyzing in the most crazy way.
The way that your Boston accent came out just then.
Oh, yeah.
Was mobster like.
Yeah, that's why I'm going Bill's Mafia, because I've always wanted to be in the Mafia.
I think you just do it.
Yeah. Well, it's actually the mob. We're Irish.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, the internet is a bizarre place. I'm like, what's it like? I mean, because we make content, mm-hmm. You know, social media posts, podcasts, podcast reviews, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even if you say, you know, I'm not going to look at that or whatever, you end up seeing stuff, even if you're trying to tunnel vision it. And so I'm just curious, because it's always a good, bad, and ugly, right?
Yeah.
What's your experience been like with just hearing the reviews of who you are as a human?
Yeah, it's kind of crazy to put something out there and... I'd say, like, I always want to put, like, good content out all the time. Mm-hmm. But sometimes it's just shit ass. And, like...
What do you mean?
Like sometimes you put something out and you're like, that's gold. I'm stoked about that. It's always the stuff you work really hard on and you're, like, proud of.
Isn't that funny how that works?
That sucks to people.
It's so true, though.
It's like, oh, damn, maybe I just stink. But it's just a bummer. But, like, a lot of people are so opinionated on just about everything you do. It's at one point, you just have to stop caring.
Yeah.
Like, feedback is good, but not when it's like so delusionally trying to just hurt you, yeah. I suppose.
It's a weird in between, because I don't think you should take the approach ever of just don't listen to them at all.
Yeah.
And just do your thing. It's like sometimes... They're right.
They're right most of the time.
And you know when they're right, because mm-hmm. it feels different. You're like, ouch.
Yeah. I mean...
You're kind of right.
Dude, when they hit me with, like, specifics that I have in the back of my subconscious about my own self...
Yes, they tickle that little insecurity. We're like, fuck.
I'm like, dude, I thought about that maybe one time, but, like, how do they know? Like, they mm-hmm. just are so spot on. It's crazy. They really know how to get you.
And they're like in the carpool line somewhere. And
yeah, like,
and they're like, I've done my work here.
Yeah.
And I'm on to my day in my life.
It's so crazy to just be a fucking troll on the internet and then go pick up your kids at fucking preschool. You piece of shit. No wonder you're divorced.
I just had that in my head. And I was picturing, you know, I actually was picturing a, like, the stay-at-home dad in that situation.
Yeah,
where
he's
mad that he's that guy right now. And he's like,
yeah.
Right?
And here's the thing. These older guys, I think I saw a tweet or a TikTok, and someone said, these older guys, at least they have balls. They have their two kids in their profile picture, where they live, where they work, all on their profile.
Come find me.
And then my generation is hiding behind, like user 123456789.
I cannot stand that.
It's like... Ay, ay, ay.
I think as a just a formality, as just a basic principle, Instagram, if somebody follows you
mm-hmm.
and they're private, you should automatically be able to see their profile.
Yep. And give me their mother's number while you're at it.
Yeah. And
I'd like to talk.
And like, yeah, give me your girlfriend's number and your mom's number. Just emergency contact stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I've went that route before. One kid, he really fucking slipped up. Called me probably like a big fatty or something. And
when was this?
Like a year ago.
Online?
Yeah. And basically, he just left his profile just completely clear as day. You could see his mom, his grandmother.
You goofed.
His grandmother had an Instagram. His mom, his grandmother, and his girlfriend blasted him. Made a TikTok about him. Kind of went mega viral.
Oh, wow.
He reached out to my work and asked for it to be removed. They said, you don't have to, but.
Right.
I was like, I think he learned his lesson. Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to shift gears to a different place here in a second.
Okay.
I was like doing some research on you today, like a psychopath.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw a post that really made me think. I saw a TikTok that you posted about mental health and stuff mm-hmm. like that.
Yeah. I'm batshit crazy.
Well, that's not what I was going
to
say.
No, it's a terrible way to bring it up.
No. And I mean, for a moment, I find you so funny on the internet.
Oh, thank you. That's huge.
I was wondering if it was a bit or not. And then I realized, oh no, she's being serious for real.
Yeah.
And I was like, then I changed my whole tune and started over again and watched it and listened to it. And it's not a fun thing to talk about, but I also feel like there is this, you know, it kind of annoys me almost how much people talk about mental health.
Yeah.
In the terms mental health, and like that's it though.
Yeah, like being so broad and saying we should all really care about our mental health.
It's like, what does that even mean?
The thing about posting that video is when I got into all this stuff, I called my mom. Mm-hmm. And I said, you're not going to like what I'm going to be posting from here on out. And you can either get with it or get lost. And at first, she unfollowed me. Oh, now damn. She's my biggest fan. She's my dog.
Did you express
so cool.
What kind of content that would be?
Just like in the comedic root of things. Okay. Like there was this one thing I posted, which sparked the conversation where I put out a poll of my two friends and I said, which one makes you cream your jeans more? She right. didn't like that.
So she knew what cream
Irish
jeans
Catholic
meant.
Household. Yeah.
She was like, I know what that is.
Yeah. She's
that's
like,
not cool.
She's, you're talking about creaming jeans on your Instagram story?
Your mom, don't say that. Don't say that, mom. God, yeah.
Like, oh, no, not you.
You're like, oh, no, God, it is bad when you say it.
But I had called her and I'm like, yeah, you're not always going to like what I have to say. And at first she wasn't with it. And then now she's right on my side. But I also talk to myself, I guess. I'm crazy.
No, I do this. I do the same thing. And I think people think I'm bullshitting. No, I've spent days in my house by myself. I mean, this already sounds wild. But I mean, I found myself single in my early 30s. And all of a sudden, I'm in a house that I bought. And, you know, people are busy doing shit.
Yeah.
And then COVID happened. And I'm just kind of like, hey, I'm a new best friend.
Yeah.
Like someone's over and you're like, yeah, like cut that shit out.
Yeah. I'm like, oh, sorry. I was talking to myself. What did you say? But yeah, no. So I was talking to myself and I just kind of made a note. Like if I'm going to do this, I'm in it and I'm going to just be 100% like authentically just tell.
Why'd you want to tell people like that?
I think it's like a really important conversation to have, mm-hmm. and not in the sense of mental health is really important.
Yeah.
But rather like just showing the bad parts of it. Like people will talk about finding out they have mental health issues, whatever, and just kind of show the good sides of it all. But press and record while you cry, and I almost regret it, but I almost don't either because for whatever reason, it helped a lot of people, I guess.
Yeah.
Just talking through it. Last year, I checked myself into the loony bin,
which
I shouldn't call it that, but that's how I cope,
not a club.
I guess.
What is it?
It is the mental health facility.
Mm-hmm.
What do you actually call it?
I mean,
I would call it like so many different awful
definitely
things.
Not the loony bin.
But, yeah, the loony bin.
Even though like you're someone who like went there, they're like, that's offensive. It's like, I can call it whatever I want. I went there. So
I'm a strong believer in if you can claim it, you can say it.
Right. Okay. I mean, it's like I've never been to that place yet.
Yeah.
So
well, there's always time.
So there's a moment in your or just a culminating moment where you're like, I want to or what are you thinking in your head?
Well, what I have now realized after a year later and being medicated now is I should have not went there and I should have went to rehab.
Okay.
Yeah. No, yeah. I had a drinking and like I was doing like a lot of blow, Molly and stuff.
Okay. So yeah. And it was kind of throwing your.
And it was just throwing like obviously it fucks up your mental health.
Uh-huh.
But like I had mental health issues, but it was the drinking and the partying and I was just being an idiot. And because for whatever reason, rehab seemed a lot more scarier than going to the loony bin.
I mean, I'll say, I've never said this before. There was a point, I mean, I had a whole moment probably 2.5-3 years ago. I had just been working so hard for years, head down, tunnel vision. You know, I had one successful podcast and I'm like, I need to make, I'm going to make this work. Mm. This is what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Give a shit.
Yeah.
Let's go. And so I busted my ass and I just kind of ended up neglecting myself a little bit there. But there was a moment, it sounds funny now, it was definitely not funny at the time. And I think it was a meeting about Dead and Gone. We hadn't made it yet. And I was literally in the bathroom crying and I called a mental health facility.
Mm.
I probably Googled mental health facility.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure it works. And I called them and I was like, I'm going to check myself in somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Not for some sort of substance abuse thing. I'm just going to go here and I'll pay for it myself right now, today. I'm like ready to go.
Yeah, like I need help.
But turns out they're like, okay, so what's going on? I was like, I'm just really anxious.
Mm.
And they're like, is that it?
How?
I'm like, yeah. Uh-huh. And they're like, okay. And they're asking all this other shit. And I'm like,
help.
I'm like, what? I'm glad I didn't do it now. I mean, yeah. Like, you know, maybe it probably would have been fine.
Yeah.
But I'm like, yo, I'm a paying customer.
Yeah.
I'm paying full price, no insurance. Let's mm-hmm. go.
Yeah, cash here.
Yeah, like run it.
Mm.
And I don't know why I thought it would work that way. I guess it doesn't yet. I mean, some places it does, right?
It's a fucked up system. Like, yeah. If you really need help urgently, you have to go to the emergency room
yeah.
to get into a place because there isn't room. And it's just crazy. Like, if you were to call, you can't just be like, oh, I can just walk in.
Yeah,
go to the emergency room, you have to be locked down. You have to get the grippy socks and
the grippy socks.
Grippy socks.
And you're like, God, can't slide.
Like, yeah. I'm like, oh, fucker. The worst thing of it all was if you're taking too long taking a shit, a girl's poop, by the way. If you're taking too long taking a shit,
have you guys heard about this?
They walk in on you, and that's when I lost my mind. I was like, you gotta be shitting me.
You're kidding me.
Like. I'm
okay,
well,
how long is too long?
Well, you know, I like to take my time.
No, but like, I'm not. Yeah, okay, well, yeah.
Well, how long is too long for you?
Oh, I would. They would think I was doing something bad in there every day.
Yeah.
They're like, why? He needs to keep going to that same bathroom every hour. Keep an eye on that guy.
Yeah.
And I'm like, no, nah, I actually have to take a shit each
time. Dude, this food sucks.
Yeah, you're like, yeah, it's like, I don't know, but my tummy hurts.
Like, I promise, everything's cool.
Yeah, that would be game over for me right there.
Yeah, I lost.
It's also why I don't ever want to go to prison.
Oh my God, no.
And I feel like even if you committed a crime, hopefully not a murder or some heinous crime, if you're someone who's in jail for anything and like you have to just take shits in front of people and stuff, I would eventually adapt, but I'm not convinced. I don't see it. I don't see how I can do that, where I could just all of a sudden be cool with that. At the very least, I would get used to it and be a problem for everybody else.
Yeah.
And I would be in more trouble.
And then you're in trouble. Yeah.
Yeah. Get my ass beat. I'm like, this just sucks.
Yeah.
Like, that's like, when I think of prison, I'm like, man, taking a shit in prison would suck.
It really would.
The first thing I think about.
I just powered two people who have been to prison and have been rehabilitated.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know if that works, but. If you like to go to prison, lose years of your life and come out and experience all that, that's a whole other world. It's crazy.
It's like a time glitch.
Yeah.
Like, that's kind of, I mean, it has to fuck you up.
It's got to fuck you up. I actually saw a TikTok. It was kind of funny. He goes, my boy just got released from prison. I brought him to the club. He doesn't know how to act. He's standing there like, just really scared.
Well, he's acting like most of my friends anyways. We're like, oh, shit. They're like, yeah, we should go like to the crib, dude.
You mean I could take a shit for as long as I want in here?
There's no time limits on the bathrooms here? It's like, yeah, but you don't want to use the bathroom here, man. Like, let's go to my apartment.
Yeah.
there's no door on this one.
Yeah.
You made this post, and I have to only think that you have so much hindsight now.
Yeah.
But you probably felt like people should hear this, right?
Yeah.
Authentically. And you kind of leaned into that, which I think is really cool, because that's not an easy thing to do, or it's not even, it's definitely not my natural inclination. And so you did that, and, you know, I hate the whole just generalization of mental health.
Yeah, yeah.
But and I like to keep it real. And like, what have you learned from that point in time?
Basically, the whole reason I think I press record and then pressed post is because that was like 3 months after I got out of no privacy shitting housing.
Right. That's what you, that's if you.
That's
you,
better. That's now. More PC.
Yeah. Yeah. It is.
And that was like 3 months to the day that I got out, and like I was like medicated, whatever. And everybody was commenting on my post saying, "You just seem so good now. Like, really proud of you. Like, everything seems great. Like, you are basically like people saying like, you are fixed." And I just kind of wanted to show like, and they were saying it in like a really nice way.
Yeah, yeah. But you're kind of like, yeah, I'm not going to post like 1,000 of those. Yeah.
Yeah, like,
I posted one. And I'm surprised I did that.
Yeah, so, yeah. I know.
Yeah.
Because I'd much rather just deflect and make a joke. That's,
of course.
That's my
same. Same here.
It's the way I get by.
Mm-hmm.
And my whole life. Yeah, seriously. I mean, it's a defense
right now.
Mechanism. I'm like, yeah, I'm fighting for my life.
I mean, podcasts are what I do.
Just want to be me, man. No, but that is me. I mean, if you don't have the shitty things happen to you, then you just, for me personally, if I didn't have shitty things happen to me, I'd be a loser. I would just be not funny at all.
Yeah.
It's like,
oh, absolutely. It's like, there's shit that's happened that's so bad, comically bad. Mm. It's like, this is absurd now. It's absurdity.
Yeah. Like, yeah. You ever find yourself in times where you're like, you can't even write this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love those times.
And I like, that's where I ultimately get, it's like really hard right before that. I'm like, this is it.
I'm like, yeah.
This is how it ends.
Here it is.
Then I'm like, what? Oh, it's worse? I'm like, all right, now this is a movie.
Yeah.
Now this is stand-up comedy. This is crazy.
So you take it, running with it. That's how you make money off of it.
And I'm like, no, I should
gotta make money off of this.
Yeah, the whole thing, like, so this has been I'm like not typically the podcast guy that has shows like this. I mean, it's the first show I've ever had like this. I've talked to plenty of people and done interviews, but I'm more of an investigative journalist kind of. I mean, not even like legitimately, just in my podcast experience.
Yeah,
I'm used to interviewing people, gathering tape and making a thing and then saying, here you go.
And that is very cool.
Well,
because it's so hard to do that.
Like, it is. They're both hard though. I looked at what you do, what we're doing right now, is like, I don't know if I can do that. And honestly, I think that for me, like, even like right now in this moment, I'm like, okay, like, what I'm doing differently consciously is just making it a conversation and just saying more than I would normally say.
Yeah.
Right.
I think people have said it. I don't want to toot my own horn, I guess, but
no, toot it.
People
toot
feel comfortable around me, man. They spill the beans.
Right.
And it's
now,
great.
You have that.
For the industry.
You're like, yeah, it's like, so if you ever need anybody. Now I'm talking like you. I'm like, it's like,
you can tell me your secrets. No one's watching.
Yeah, it's like, cool, like, upload that shit now. Yeah. Do you regret posting?
All the time.
Really?
Wait, oh, sorry. I thought you just meant, do you regret?
Have you ever regret?
I
just the question mark regret.
I do digress and I do regret.
Oh, yeah. We all regret shit.
No, regretting posting. I don't know. Sometimes I'll post shit and I'm like, that was fucking not funny. My whole thing is like, I want to be funny at all times.
What parameter are you basing this off of?
My own personal.
Like just an engagement level that you can see that feels like that worked?
Yeah.
Kind of?
Yeah, well, no, I not even that. Like, I don't even care how well anything does, like likes or whatever. It's more of, if I watch it back and I still think it's funny, I'm like, okay, that I stand by that. That's funny. And then everyone in the comments can be like, oh, this is hilarious. And I'm like, you're all idiots because that's really bad and I don't know why I posted it. And it's just,
yeah,
it's a whole runaround with
that's
what
I respect about what you do, actually.
Yeah.
And like, what scares me about what I'm doing right now is that, you know, I'm like, I'm kind of a little, I mean, it's probably fine, but I'm a little nervous about, oh, like me in this one moment in time. I mean,
yeah,
in 2 days from now, I'll be looking back. I'm like, wow, what was I thinking? What was I saying?
Yeah.
And I think people don't really get that. Mm-mm. I mean, there's some people who just out there just going and they're just spewing the same shit every day.
Yeah.
And whoever they are.
And they're out of their goddamn minds.
And they're insane.
Yeah.
But people just say stuff and they're like, okay, you know, it's usually not that deep.
Yeah.
It isn't anywhere else in life. If there's a pattern of it, sure, yeah. But I don't know. It's like people could, I don't know, just should look at it differently than it is.
Yeah. It's just sometimes you're your own worst enemy.
So do you regret posting that video or has there been anything that was helpful to you about that?
I don't regret it just because there were a bunch of people who reached out and like, the people who followed me were like all friends. So like it felt like two friends like trying to help each other out through bad times and people just saying like, really glad you posted this because, mm-hmm. you know, you made it look like everything was great and it's just not. And do I want to look like a big crybaby online? Not so much.
Yeah, no, that's why I'm asking.
Yeah.
Because not that I thought that you looked that way at all.
You thought I looked like a big crybaby.
I'm like, she's a little crybaby, but
she's no. bawling her eyes out to the point where I thought was a bit.
that's a level of vulnerability that I don't even know if I could do.
Yeah, it's weird because like I'll do the funny stuff, but then mm-hmm. sometimes I'll do like the here's my life stuff.
Yeah.
And that's when I'm in a creative rut with
yeah.
the funny stuff.
I get that.
Which I'm currently in. I'm just like.
It happens though.
It's like, it's tough, man.
It's not always. Yeah. It's like a weird, like just thing with it all. And
yeah. It's
you can tell. I can feel it. It's a weird. I mean, I don't even know if this is probably just my own brain
yeah.
making this up, but there's this up and down and I can tell when I'm on the surge of it
mm-hmm.
and when I'm back down again sometimes.
Yeah.
And when I'm going up on it, I'm like, I feel like I'm hitting so hard that mm-hmm. I can even just like deja vu like call what's about to happen or that I'm just a lost puppy again.
Yeah.
And I'm like, whoa, what's going on?
When those creative juices are flowing, they're flowing.
Yeah.
But when they don't, it feels like it's never coming back. You know?
Yeah, it feels like that's actually thank you for saying that because I would have not said it unless you said it.
Mm-hmm.
But that's how I used to feel.
And it's like debilitating.
I've learned that it's just not true.
Yeah.
Just factually, for me, is untrue.
Yeah.
That no matter what, it always comes back.
It always comes back.
And like, I tell myself that. It doesn't always fix it.
Yeah.
But I'm like, okay, we're here again.
Yeah.
You know, these ones suck, but I'm like, it always comes around.
It always comes back
it
around.
It does, and it always has.
Have you ever found yourself in a creative rut and done something to get yourself going again? Or is it because I feel like, I don't know.
I mean, totally.
Yeah.
And I think that's always kind of changed and evolved a little bit. For me, I think more so these days, and I kind of learned it over time, is people like these guys, just, you know, if I'm all burnt out and confused, you know, odds are that not everyone around you in that moment is.
Mm.
I'm not trying to offload anything on anybody, but I think people...
It's not contagious.
Yeah. And it might be reversed in a month, a year, or whatever.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, I collectively feeling the excitement about something
that's
reminds
huge.
Me
yeah.
that, damn. And for me, it's... If it's not that, then it just feels like a whole worthless, selfish venture.
Like, what's it worth?
And, you know, the internet would say otherwise, that I would just, you know, my head's so big that I just want to do this because, but like, I'm uncomfortable.
Yeah.
But, and I just have just gotten used to it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, fuck it.
Yeah.
What else am I going to do?
What else are you going to do?
I think that's okay, though. I've learned so much doing that, and I don't regret it at all. Like, it's been more good than bad. So have you learned anything about yourself, though? What have you learned about yourself?
I guess I've noticed within the last year that I'm, like, hyper self-aware, which is, like, a good thing and a bad thing.
Mm-hmm.
I tried therapy, and it was, like, this young, I think she was, like, younger than me. Like, this young girl right out of college. And I thought it would be great because she'd like understand like the online stuff maybe, but whatever. And I'm talking to her and she's like, wow, you are just so self-aware. And I'm like, yeah, help. Like, give me tools, something. She's like, I don't know. You're just like really self-aware.
I'm glad you said that too, because that's like, how I felt. I'm like, no, I don't want to go through 6 months of this for you to get who I am.
Yeah.
I'm like, no, I'm aware of all these things mostly.
Yeah.
There's some that I could use some insight on.
I'm just looking for a little help here.
Yeah. Like, yeah, give me a little boost here. Yeah. Just say I'm doing a good job.
Yeah. She's like, yeah.
Give me a hug,
I think
please.
That's really, yeah. I was like, just fucking listen if you're not going to be helpful.
And they're like, hey, like, you're doing really good. And you're like, that doesn't help. Yeah.
No shit. I wonder why I skipped the last 2 weeks. That's when I wasn't doing good.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, it's now I think I just know like it, I got diagnosed with bipolar. So it's like, And I still don't know if I agree with that diagnosis.
Why is that though? Just because you felt bipolar doesn't mean you're, I mean, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I thought at one point in my life, in my early 20s, I was like, I was convinced I had bipolar.
Yeah.
Disorder, one of them. I'm not really sure.
Mm-hmm.
And shit, maybe I do.
Yeah.
But it doesn't feel that way to me anymore though, like that.
You're desperate for an answer and then you get the answer and you don't like it.
Yeah, but like also I think that there's such a scale to it all. It's just a name we assigned to. I mean, it's not like it's a bug bite.
Yeah, no.
Or like COVID.
Yeah. And it's just funny that you said that you thought at one time that you could have been bipolar, but also with the conversation we just had about the creative highs and lows.
I wonder if that
ties into it all, because like when things are good, like my brain's going, I'm moving, I'm grooving.
Yeah.
And then when things are bad, it's like, I'm not creative. I harp on all that.
I mean, I really don't know, to be honest, but I've learned how to get myself out of the rut sometimes. Sometimes I can't.
Mm.
And there's times where it doesn't matter if I can get myself out of the rut or not.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, guess what? You got to do this today.
Yeah.
And tomorrow and the next day. And you're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
And so I think I learned a lot through that, too, of just, hey, sometimes it just sucks. And just accepting that for what it is.
Yeah. If you can just...
knowing that it's not going to be forever.
Yeah. And just know it's not going to be forever. It's like, we got to rough through this. It's gonna get better. Because it always does. It always does.
That's what I was convinced that, like, every time I felt like this is it. This is the worst it's ever been, and it's not getting better this time.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm almost, I feel stupid almost how wrong I was.
I know.
It might be a longer stretch.
Yeah.
That happens.
Yeah.
But it's, I mean, for me so far, it's proved my own self wrong.
Mm-hmm. Which is the only time you want to be wrong,
right? Exactly. Yeah, like I'll take that one.
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm like, yeah, no, you know that. Chalk that up to me.
No, but yeah,
it's funny to compare. Even when you were like younger, when you think it's the end of the world, you get in trouble.
Yeah,
it's like you get caught drinking in high school, and you're like, I'm never gonna get over this. Like everything's awful. My parents hate me. They're never gonna forgive me. I do that in small doses as an adult.
What do you mean?
About like silly stuff. Like, I don't know. Like, when I first wanted to get this job, they wouldn't take me. I'm like, oh, I don't know what the hell else I'm going to do. And like, you think it's the end of the world, but it's not.
Okay. You mean like defeated?
Yeah. It's like, there's times in your life where you think it's the end of the world and it's just not. I don't know if that's.
Yeah, no. Yeah, that's actually a good point too, because and also I think it's kind of, I mean, at least in society that I grew up in my generation, and probably for a lot of people today, which is like my generation, it's like, I mean, probably everyone who's listening to this fucking podcast.
We were on MySpace.
Yeah, we used to use MySpace. Also, like, don't act like you don't want MySpace back.
Yeah, that would be pretty sick.
Like, you mean like some retrofitted new MySpace wouldn't be as cool as TikTok? Sure about that?
Sure.
You sure about that? That's why.
Love that show.
Dude, that guy is, I mean.
He rocks.
He's awesome. I'm so glad that show is just being made at all.
Yeah, I know.
I'm like, dude, that's a win for society.
I know. Sketch comedy is
right?
really the best.
We need that stuff. No, I mean, I used to love the improv stuff. Like, I mean, in just even middle school and high school, drama class.
Yeah.
You know? Because I mean, because the drama, like, club in my school was weird.
Weirdos. And I really wish I could look
it
past that.
It wasn't Glee. It wasn't any of that cool shit. It mm-hmm. was weird.
I wish I could have looked past it because I would have been a star, but mm-hmm. I just was too cool. It was too cool to do
like,
it.
Yeah, I'm not a loser.
I'm like, yeah. You're doing Macbeth? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, like, yeah, like, that's why I learned it wasn't for me, is that we did improv like most of the day in class. Everyone was like laughing, and then they're like, oh, who's going to be this play? I was like, I was the only one who thought it was stupid.
No, really?
And I was like, okay.
Maybe I belong.
It's not cool if I can't be like, this is lame. Okay. And I feel like it is. Okay.
Yeah. I actually have a really funny story. I'm really big into theater, acting, whatever. I really wanted to be a star. I wanted to be Lindsay Lohan so bad when I was younger.
You're a rock star.
Really did. Rock star, 2 eggs. But just real quick, I tell this story all the time, but when I was younger, my mom signed me up for an acting camp.
Okay.
And it was right down the street
from
me.
I heard about those. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
Yeah. And I went to the camp, and it was like in this little cabin place, whatever, but it was like during the week, whatever. I loved it. I was a shining star. I got the lead of whatever play it was. And they invited the parents to come see the dress rehearsal before the big show. And so my mom comes and we put on the play. And at the end, I'm like, Mom, fucking killed it, right? You should fucking get me an agent because I'm going to be the next big thing. We get in the car. She doesn't say anything, which I'm like, all right, you're a bitch.
My mom's such a bitch. And you said that, right? She said, you're all right. Bitch, and she's
fuck
like,
you, Nancy.
Yeah,
no, my mom's my boy. I would never say that. I was so afraid
Sorry,
of her.
Nancy. Don't say that to your mom.
So good. No, don't ever say that to my mom.
Yeah,
but we get in the car, and I'm like, all right, yeah. So, what'd you think?
Mm-hmm.
And she goes, yeah. So that's gonna be your last day at the camp. And I was like, what do you mean? The show's literally tomorrow. I'm the star.
What?
And as it turns out, it was a camp for special needs kids. So, wasn't very
fair. Is
this
a real story?
I promise you, I can't make this shit up.
I mean, because, it'd be more fucked up if it wasn't true, I guess.
I don't know. I lived it so I can say it.
I mean, you're still a star, but...
tell my mom.
Yeah, I guess the pool you're in does matter to a degree.
Yeah, it's not
very scale of what you mean by that, but...
Yeah.
Did you have fun?
I had a blast.
Okay, then. Did they have fun?
I basically should have been running around yelling, one of us, one of us.
Were you just like, were you pissed?
I was shooting the shit. These kids were my boys. This was like my little secret thing.
There was
not
any part of you that was like, is this like one of those kids?
No, I was like, these guys suck at acting.
You're like no, I might be a good actor.
I looked around, I'm like... I don't think acting's for them, but I mean, if I'm going to shine, I'm going to shine.
Any listener who found the mental health, and I hate that term.
No, it's all good. I mean, what else are you going to say?
And I know you know what I mean.
Like crybaby posts.
No, but like, I think that it was probably more helpful than it was. I mean, not that it wasn't a thing for you to deal with now that you did that, but I think that it's bold, and there's probably more people, in my opinion, that saw that are like, thank you, because I'm too scared to say that in my life. And I don't even have your life where you talk all the time.
Yeah.
And that to me was so badass about it.
Yeah. A lot of people are just like quietly going through it. And it's like, if I could be the voice for some people, that's pretty cool. But I also don't really see it that way. But
it's not even like that. I just mean like, you know.
I mean, even you sharing whether you keep it or not, but like you sharing how you felt, it's good to have like an open dialogue about
I'm always curious what other people think,
mm-hmm.
you know, like, and like I was genuinely curious, like,
yeah,
how did you feel? Like, what were you thinking? Like, is that how I think, or am I different than that, or is it, I don't know, or just what? Because it is all different.
I mean,
everyone's thinking. We have different brains out here.
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, life's about like human connection. If you, the more you talk to people, the more you understand how they feel, which could help you understand how you feel, I guess. I don't know. It sounded like I'm smoking weed.
Are you sure it's just 10%?
Yeah, brother.
Just 10?
Yeah, those things will get you.
Just 10.
And only $2.
Like, actually, though?
Yeah.
Like,
dude, it's a college.
Like, 8 quarters? Like,
21 plus is a stream.
$2?
$2. $3? For $4?
I don't know.
Between 2 and 4.
Well,
ask me any other question like, about it. I don't really remember
like
how much
it's like either this or double that. Mm-hmm. You're like, whoa.
You can get 2 for either.
No, I have only, I mean, I still have a little bit left here. And yeah, it feels like more than 10%. In a good way?
That's your bang for your buck.
It's that malt liquor vibe. You know what I mean? It's that gas station.
It's that gas.
It's that gas, dude. Yeah.
It's that gas, man.
It's that Friday night, like, hey, man, like, let's go to the gas station and get those things.
Yeah.
And it's these.
It's those things.
I will say, honestly, I've actually enjoyed the taste the whole time.
That's so
maybe rich. I have a...
Will you say it one more time right there?
Oh, yeah. Hi. This is Pirate Water, and they're actually not bad. I kind of like them.
They're really good.
I mean, I'm not going to drink them every day because that'd be crazy. Just, you know, every other day.
When you want to let loose, man.
Yeah, no, actually, it's pretty good. Fuck and you, yeah. I hope you get some shit out of that because...
Yeah. You have to go get it. Yeah.
Yeah. Every time you say it, you get...
I'll get a smile. I got a smile.
Get a penny. Yeah. But also, you know, thank you for this. This has been fun.
Yeah.
And, you know...
Thanks for having me. This is
I know
awesome.
We don't know each other like that, but yeah. Now we do.
I mean,
but
dude, it's right here.
Also, yeah, no,
boy,
I appreciate just like... the fuck it vibe of like, yeah, I'll go. And I'm like, cool. I think that told me all that I needed to know.
Yeah.
And like, I'll, you know,
down for
let's
whatever
keep it up,
all
man.
Times.
Yeah, like, yeah. This is, and also a huge fan. Like,
right back at you, man.
Yeah. So,
we're boys now.
Cheers. Yeah, like, we're basically like,
we're like,
like we're friends.
We
like,
all
honestly.
Go back 10 years,
yeah.
Right?
Let's go to summer camp. Yeah, well, yeah.
Unless you got another one.
Okay. Is that a bad way to end it? Probably.
I think that's a good way to end it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Talking to Death is a production of Tenderfoot TV and iHeartPodcasts, created and hosted by Payne Lindsey. For Tenderfoot TV, executive producers are Payne Lindsey and Donald Albright. Co-executive producer is Mike Rooney. For iHeartPodcasts, executive producers are Matt Frederick and Alex Williams, with original music by Makeup and Vanity Set. Additional production by Mike Rooney, Dylan Harrington, Sean Nerney, Dayton Cole, and Gustav Wild for Cohedo. Production support by Tracy Kaplan, Mara Davis, and Trevor Young. Mixing and mastering by Cooper Skinner and Dayton Cole. Our cover art was created by Rob Sheridan. Check out our website, talkingtodeathpodcast.com.